young in South Carolina, I idolized my father. My father meant the world to me. He was everything to me, and I wanted to do everything I could to impress him. And my father did a lot of things for all of us and our family. So as a young girl in high school, we would get together, all of us kids, and go and meet my dad in the evening, because he cleaned up several doctor's offices. And we would go and we would assist him in cleaning up those doctor's offices so that he could get home early enough to sit down with the family and have a great meal. And it was during that time that the first idea of having a business, the epiphany of having a business came to me, when I turned to my siblings and I said, hey, we should start a janitorial business. Well, that didn't happen. Now, if you knew my father, you knew that once you graduated high school, you were going to go to college. All of us. He wanted us to be something more than he was. My dad worked so hard. He was a preacher on Sundays, and he was a janitor during the week. And so, of course, when I graduated high school, I went on to Tuskegee Institute in Alabama, where I received my Bachelor's of Science degree. I always knew I wanted to be an entrepreneur. I wanted to be my own boss. And so later on, at around 2009, well, when I came to Columbus, once I graduated college, and I came to Columbus, my dad said, you need to go to Columbus and live with your sister, who was here at Ohio State getting her master's. So I came to Columbus, and I worked for the Ohio State University. It was my very first job. I stayed there for about 4 years. And then I found myself with the city of Columbus, and I worked there as an orientation instructor with the CEDAR program. And then I left there, and I went to General Motors. And I stayed there 15 years as a manufacturing supervisor. Now, it was during that time that I discovered I did not want to stay at General Motors and have the UAW breathing down my back. So I decided I would go back to school and make my way out of GM. So I went back to school, to Ohio University, where I received my MBA in general business. It was during this time, when I was working for General Motors, that I had the epiphany of starting a business. When I walked out of General Motors and having sold my seniority, I said to my sister, I will not ever be coming back here again. I really did not like the manufacturing scene, but today, my life has turned full circle. I am back in manufacturing. So, as I began to, when I got my MBA degree and I left General Motors, I started my very first business, which was billing made perfect. I had a billing company for physicians. And I did the medical billing for at least 9 physicians. When they decided they were not going to pay me on time, I said, oh, I got to do something about this. And that is when I went to Columbus City School and became a substitute teacher. Now, after that, during that particular time, I met my husband. My husband and I, we got married. And in 2001, and around 2009, we were in South Carolina, and we were right after a nice family meal. We were sipping on sweet tea, and I said to all of my family members, wow, we should be making and selling this sweet tea to the world. Well, again, I didn't get an amen. No one in the room thought that was a good idea. So on the way back to Columbus, I said to myself, come hell or high water, I'm going to make this sweet tea and see what it does. And so I began making this sweet tea, taking it to my church, taking it and letting anyone that tried to taste it, wanted to taste it, taste it. One day I found myself in the Creole kitchen down on Mount Vernon Avenue, and I said to Chef Henry Butcher, probably some of you in this room know about Chef, and I said to him, man, this sandwich would taste good if I had some of my sweet tea to wash it down. And he said, oh, you make sweet tea? And I said, yes. He said, well, why don't you bring me some and see if I like it? So I did, and he loved it. And so it was right after that that I brought in some sweet tea, gave him gallons of sweet tea to test it on his customers, and they loved it. He served it free, and of course it was free, so I knew they would love it, but they really did. So, right after that, having made that tea, I went down into my very first farmer's market, which was Pearl Alley Farmer's Market. And at that time, I didn't know what I was doing. All I was doing was making tea and trying to sell it. And so Bob Kramer, where are you, Bob? Okay. Bob Kramer walked up on me, and he had just retired or left the City of Columbus, Capital Department. And he said, Ms. Chapman, I don't think that you should be doing this like that. And I said, okay. Because I mean, I was like shaking in my shoes when he said that. So anyway, he said, the way to get away from that is to bottle it. So I became a bottler. And so now I bottle my tea up at Ohio State University under the direction of the FDA. I don't bottle my tea, but I bottle my other two products at Ohio State along with my husband. So that's how I got started. And then there was a guy in Pearl Alley who made spaghetti sauce. He walks over to me and he said to me, hey, if you want to know how to do what you're doing, you need to go see ECDI. And it was then that I came to ECDI and later the Women's Business Center, sat down with Ellen Harvey, and Ellen Harvey and Bob, I forget his, Bob Lee, he set me down and they told me how to go about doing what I was doing. They had me cross every T and dot every I. They were the ones that sent me to Ohio State University to make my tea in the beginning. And Ohio State University had me go to Cornell University in New York as a process authority, and I still use them today. They tell me how to make my products safe, how to acquire a shelf life of 1 year, and how to do all the things necessary to make the product safe for the buying public. So now that's what I do. Okay. And so I just want to say thank you, Ellen. In your absence, and thank all of you for coming out today, because without you, this little old girl from South Carolina would not have been able to do what she's done. Thank you.